Hello and welcome back to our channel Nursery to Varsity. So in this video we are going to understand what are the JavaScript operators. So whenever we listen the word operators, we think that we have to apply any operator on either string or on any number. So how can we do that? It's very easy to do that. There are some operators that we study in the JavaScript. These are arithmetic, comparison, assignment, bitwise, logical, and type operator. So let's get started with the first one, that is arithmetic operators. The first arithmetic operators we can have with us are plus, minus, star, exponentiation, division, modulus, increment and decrement. So what does the addition do? That's normal. When we have to add any two numbers, we can do the add operator. Similarly, we have subtract operator, we have multiplication, we have division, modulus, increment and decrement. We can have a look at one of them, that we can see the multiplication operator, how it works. This is a very simple code. For the multiplication operator, we can have this. You will write, I have written here one arithmetic operator star. Let me zoom the little bit code. Okay. See, this is, I have written in heading the arithmetic operator PID is equals to try to, and in script we have taken three variables, variable A, variable B and variable C. And we have performed the star operator here, that is the multiplication operator here. And in document.getElementById, I have written try to and .innerHTML is equals to C. So in this way, we can perform the multiplication operator. And when you will perform this, you will get the output as 1000. Okay. So in the following manner, you can perform all the arithmetic operator. Try it by yourself. If you face any problem, you can mail your queries. The mail ID is given in the description below. And yes, we will discuss it in the next videos that we are that going to come. Okay. So the next operator is comparison operator. What does that do? Whenever we have any two variables or any two means whenever we having the two variables that contains either the number or floating point number or any string, we can perform the comparison operator. So for that we can perform the comparison operator. So how can we do that? If we want to check any values that either it is having a equal or not, we can perform the equal to operator. Triple equal to is a strictly equal operator, means equal value and equal type. They should have the same type as well as value, not equal. You can see in the image I have taken. Okay. It's greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equals to, and ternary operator. What is ternary operator? In ternary operator, we have question mark as well as colon. It works similarly like that of if and else. If you have studied if and else in the C or any other programming language, you people are clear what does the ternary operator mean. Whenever we write any condition in the if part, and That means the first portion is equal, we can pass it to the one value, and if the another one is equal, we can pass it to the second value. We will see this ternary operator when we are going to understand the if and else operators. Okay. Now the third operator that we are having with us is the assignment operator. How can we perform the assignment operator? See, in assignment operator, whenever we want to pass any value, for example, you assign the variable x is equals to 2. That equal to is assigning the value to the variable x. Okay. So how can we write plus equal to? Plus equal to is similarly like x is equals to x plus y. As you can see that on the right hand side, we are having the example of different types. So in this, we can see that this is a shorthand property, plus equal to. Whenever you want to perform x is equals to x plus y, you can write either like this, or there is a shorthand property, that is x plus equals to y. Both means the same. Now the next one is also similarly like that, that is x minus equals to y. Similarly, x star is equals to y, x division is equals to y, x modulus is equals to y, and x exponential is equals to y. The middle table means the middle column has all the shorthand property. How can we write the shorthand assignment operators? And on the right side, we are having the detailed. Okay. The next one is bitwise operator. How can we perform the bitwise operator? Okay. See, the first bitwise operator is AND. How can we perform the AND function? See, whenever you write 5 and 1, okay. So the example, this image I have taken from the Google. Okay, I'm going to make you understand what these example work. Okay, so we have 5. How can we write the 5? We can write the 5 in the binary form as 0101, and similarly we can write 001. Okay, so as we know, whenever we apply the AND operators, we have 0.0 is equals to 0. It only gives us the 1 when we have 1.1. Both the inputs are 1 and 1, then we get the output 1. Else, or the cases, we get 0 only. So similarly in this, we get 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, again 0, and 1 when we got 1. So the answer is 1. The second one is OR operator. How can we perform the OR operator? In OR operator, when the 0 and 0, we get the 0. Otherwise, we get always the 1. Okay. So in this, the output is 5. Negation, not. Negation, this sign is called negation. Okay. For when we perform the negation 5, what happens? You have that binary number, it gets complemented. You take the 1's complement, means 1 get converted to 0. 0 get converted to 1. Okay. The next one is XOR. How the XOR works? Write it in the binary form, and when we have 0 and 0, the output is 0, or when we have 1 and 1, the output is 0. Means whenever we have the same input for both the variables, we get the output 0, and when we have the different values for both the inputs, we get the output 1. So in this way, we get the output 4. Now, there after that, we have less than operators. We can say that these are called the left shift operators. Okay, but these are zero fill left shift. Means, for example, you have 5 less than 1. What you have to do? You have to just write the 5 in the binary form. That is 010. Now what you have to do, you have to do the right shifting. Whenever you will do the right shifting, you will get one column blank. That one column will be filled with 0. Okay. So you can see that we have 0, 1, 0, 1. So now shift it to left. Means the first value, in the first place we will get 1. On second place we will get 0. And on third place we will get 1. And the fourth place will get blank. So that blank will be filled with 0. Okay. In this way, the code will be, decimal form will be 10. Okay. First of all, we will see the last one. What is that? We have triple greater than sign. Okay, that are zero fill right shift. What that means? That means whenever you will do the right shifting, that are filled with 0. How can we do that? Write 010 and triple equal, triple sign greater than and 1. How can we do that? Just shift these value to the right. And how many times? Only one time. So whenever you will shift these value, we get the first position will get shifted to second one, second to third one, and third to fourth one. And the first place will get empty. So in that empty place, we will fill it with 0. Okay. Now, so how different this, we have the last one is triple greater than, and the last second one is only 2 greater than sign. So how it is different? Whenever you are having the 2 greater than sign only, then you will filled with sign right shift. Means the sign right shift means it will be filled with 1. Means how can we do that? We have 0, 1, 0, 1. Greater, greater 1. Whenever you will shift it to the right, we will get shifting 0. Means you will perform 0, 0, 1, 0. And we will get the output 2. Okay. Now we have the another operator with us, that is the logical operator. In logical operator, we have three values, that is AND, OR, and not. Okay, these are also similar to this. Okay, but this is bitwise and this is logical. What's the difference? Here we are getting the value, but here we are getting the true or false. It will only work in true and false manner. Otherwise, the things are same. How? See, we have, for example, x is less than 10 and y greater than 1. For any value, if you are doing the AND operator, we will get the output. Okay, so if you apply that with any value, and we will check that, this is by taking some example. Okay, so if both the condition are true, then we will get either true, or if the first condition is, in all other cases we will get the output 0 only, means false only. Okay, next one is OR operator. How OR operator works? OR operator works if both the condition are, means one of the condition, if 0 and 0, we will get the output 0, as x is equals to 5. Now let us take the value of x and y is 5. So 5 is equal to 5, 5 is equal to 5 is equal to 5. That is right. First one is also 0. The output of second one is also 0. And 0 plus 0 is 0. So we are getting the output false. Okay. Next one is NOT operator. NOT operator works if the something, if we take some value and that's not, we do it not equal to. So we'll get the output in that manner. Okay. Now we have with us the string operator. The string operator, for this we will use the plus sign. It can also be used for the concatenation of the string. Let's see how. See, we have with us this. Okay, we have taken two text, text 1 and text 2, and we have performed the string operator. What will it do? It will add both the strings. How? Let's see with an example. See, near to one, it get added the both the string. Okay, so the next one is how we can perform the concatenation of the strings, that is adding a number and a string will always result in a string. Okay, see, we have taken one paragraph with an id, and in a script we have taken xyz. okay, we have written that whenever you will add a number and a string, it will always result in a string. Let's see, we have written here 50 plus 50, it will result in 100. See, okay, now whenever you will do the concatenation, you will see that adding a number, that is 50, with a string, you will get a string. See, 50 50, and next also hello 50. So in this way the concatenation works. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned and don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and also you can like us on all our pages, and link to the pages is given in the description below. Thank you.